let me do the math on this. You know what I mean? Ratchet, what was the 50-50 question? Or are you saying what was your question from your answer?
Oh, as far as fault and choosing.
So yeah, you said what was the answer?
You said something along the lines of women giving it up too easy, not getting to know a guy. And I said, whether you give it up on the first night or 90 days later, listening to Steve Harvey, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you don't get to, that man will put on a face until he gets what he wants. So sometimes you don't initially know who that person is until later on down the line. So my question to you and the guys is, what do you guys recommend a woman do so that she's not wasting her value and giving it up too easy and choosing the wrong guys? Like, how long does it take
you gotta
to know a man?
Yeah, you gotta vet better. And you trying to vet a man, you don't know enough about men to vet them. You need another man to help you vet that man. There's a questions in a conversation that I'll have a man with a man, the same conversation you'll have, but I'll get different answers. And I'll be able to discern it differently, best because I'm experienced and I'm a man, you know? Also, motherfuckers is aiming too high. A nigga will have sex with you all day, but he ain't never gonna marry you because you ain't pretty enough for him. And so what we need to do is find people that kind of match, right? So they see you how they supposed to see you. But you getting a nigga because you got good cheeks and you got good head. So he's 6'5". He playing in the NBA. He gonna keep fucking you to the cows going home, but he ain't gonna marry you. But y'all think because you keep sucking him off, he is. No. Find a nigga that match you. All y'all niggas is average. Period.
Ooh,
all
y'all. You gonna stop saying that shit. You gonna stop saying
no,
that
seriously.
Shit.
Ooh. Everybody on screen, 99% of the chat is average.
Nigga.
To who? Now the question is, to who? To you or to who?
Who the fuck is you talking to? I don't. Nigga. You that don't accent. Know me. Fuck out of here.
How do I, what do you mean? What do I need to know?
Me. I don't give a fuck whose show this is. None of that shit, Dana. You got me fucked up. Who the fuck you put me on the show with? No,
everybody.
For real. I don't do no disrespect. No, fuck that. Peace. You can kiss my motherfucking ass, Tubbo. I'm an average nigga. You motherfucking average with gold lights in your background, bitch. Who the fuck is you talking to?
Yeah, so everybody's average. Point blank, period. The majority of people are average. And it's okay to be average, right? Because that's the majority of the world. People think average is an insult because they never had a real conversation before. Right? And you see the results. Why is being average so offensive?
I just asked to who, right? Because, like, to who?
Mm-hmm.
Like, so when I hear that, right? And throughout my life, I've been around all facets and salaries of men, right? And all looks and stuff like that. To me, when I hear stuff like this, it only comes from a certain type of or group of guys. And it's like, why does what you think about me matter if I'm not even thinking about you, right? So if you're out here dating and you're getting, right? Because they say, oh, women think they all that. You just average, but your head is so big. It's because in real life, the men that are attracted to said woman or that like said woman, they probably get approached a lot. Whereas when you're on a public platform or you're online, because I hear this a lot online, I don't, like Dana said, you don't hear these kind of conversations in real life. So it's kind of
But that's, see, it doesn't, you're not, so you're not hearing things in real life, right? But what do our results show? Right. So not saying you specifically, but women are single. The amount of women that are single is on the rise. Right. So we got to assess why that is. So if
didn't
we
say it's more women than men.
But the amount of single women is on the rise because black men are divesting from black women.
Not even that. Black men are dying at rapid numbers. So with us still living and continuing on our lives, and men are, you know, Black, if we're talking about culture and ethnicity and stuff like that, it's deeper than that. But back to the topic at hand, I don't think it's anything wrong with people saying, hey, I'm average, let me find somebody on my level, right? But mm-hmm. when men just say that to women in general, it's like, but why should I, you know, people get offended because they're like, I'm not even looking at you. I'm not even thinking, why would I care about what you think I look mm-hmm. like? I'm not even trying to date you. And not you specifically, but even men on online platforms. It's like when I, in real life, the shit that I pull.
All right. You going on. So here's the thing.
That's why people get offended. That's what I'm saying.
Being average is not offensive. Because the majority of the world is average. The problem is nobody never told y'all. And you think because you're getting dick that you're not average. And I'm not saying you, but that's what happens to women. Because more than dick. No, yeah, you got a boyfriend or something, right?
Yeah, I'm secure. Yeah.
Shout out to that nigga. So what happens is you can post a picture half nude and you get 1,000 likes. You think that people see you as that. And that's not the case, right?
I agree.
Because I said, all y'all niggas is average. Everybody on camera is average. 99% of the chat is average, right? But internally, it'll bother you if you think it might be true. Like, it gets on Dana's nerves when I say that. But she looks at herself as above that. So she's like, nigga, shut up, right? But if you think it might be true, that shit hitting a little different.
Go ahead, somebody wanna go? Yeah, no, I was shocked the first time I heard it, but I was like, I mean, yeah. You know, like, I'm not gonna argue with you.
No,
I'm fine. Because he didn't say average the first time, second time, fourth, third time. Yeah, he was like, all y'all niggas. He didn't say average. He said y'all are like between threes and sixes. That was a different way of saying y'all are average. That's not the same fucking conversation. That's not the fucking.
The first time,
I ain't no motherfucker.
Yeah, no, he did say that.
But he said it multiple times. That's what I'm saying. Like he's rated us, but then he's also
All you need. Yeah.
Like, so it's like I guess I'm used to hearing it now. But yeah, but I know better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me read these super chats before we get too far behind. Savvy Recovery with the $2. Dana, I'm sorry to upset you. Is Goddess better?
Why is he talking to me? Like, keep my name out your fucking mouth, weirdo.
And Dr. Pepper is trash. John Henry with the $2. Thanos was right. Because it's stupid. Where you get that emoji from? Savage with the $2. Goddess, don't settle. Men are trash or gay. God. Mike Brown with the $2. Which six is a must-have if chosen one? That's an interesting question. So six, well, I already know Ratchet's answer. 6 figures is more important than him being 6 feet or having a 6-inch penis. Right, Ratchet?
Hold on, say that one more time.
I'm see if I got your answer right. So, you know, they say 6 figures, 6-inch penis, 6 foot tall. Mm-hmm. I said for Ratchet, the 6 figures would be most important.
Ain't nobody saying 6-inch penis ever. They said 6-pack.
Oh, I thought it was, I don't know.
Nobody looking for no 6-inch penis.
I don't care for 6-packs. I don't even like my men all well.
She said that. And so here's the ill thing about Ratchet, some of her perspective. She don't even be going for all that other shit. And she's successful in relationships, which kind of speaks to my point. You know what I'm saying? The stereotypical stuff, except for the bag. You know what I'm saying? Caesar's Palace with the $5. Not even 1% of all men are in jail in the USA. Why are women even bringing up these guys? We have 20 plus million men. You guys can pick from. Yeah.
He said what? 20 million men?
Yeah.
That you guys can pick from. Us, that we can pick from. That's
what. But I think it's only what, 14 million Black Americans?
I don't know what to say.
I think it's like, I don't know. He could clarify. Savage with $2. Goddess, don't settle. John the Baptist with the $5. Ratchet, to get the best results, stay a virgin and require a ring in marriage before sex. Ratchet, and the thing about it, Ratchet actually made it further down that path than most, than I think most women. Because when you say you, you got cheeks for the first time and you're 25, right?
No.
You lied to me?
Bruh.
Thanks for nothing. Savage with the $2.
Are you serious? What?
I believe you.
I'm average, but damn. I'm not average. Fuck.
You got it, so all 12 out of 10. Unpopular truth with the $5. Hemp, see how the women didn't have your back, but they want you to have theirs. Dana left you hanging. She did? God damn.
Hey, Hemp.
Yo.
From now on, not talking about her. You want me to handle your lightweight? That's what you want me to do? Come on, man. Get out of here.
They didn't really say much. I don't know. She's just kind of going. Right? She has a bad microphone, so. I think she was trying to go off, but yeah. That's ill, though, her response to being called average.
Again, she doesn't watch the show, so there's not a lot of context, and that's a natural reaction for a lot of people.
That is. I was about to say that. That's a normal. Yeah. Any of my friends would have been up here going off.
They would have been offended, but they don't know you. They don't know the show, so it's a little bit different. So I get it.
So you to realize that your average is offensive. Interesting.
No, because it comes off as insulting.
Oh, to be average?
Yeah. Because you when you phrase it, like, I don't care. Like, you can't ever insult me, but I know you. And I've been up here a million times when you called me average, and I'm going to, you know, bite back. But the way that you say it, it definitely can come off as insulting for somebody who's hearing it for the first time and doesn't have any context or, you know, doesn't know where you're getting at by it.
Mm. Okay, I mean, it makes sense, especially when people pussy. Matt Pearson with the $5. Congratulations on the 10K. Keep podcasting during baby making hours. Time to lay the wood. FYI, she was trash for that. Shaking my head. Keep your cool, bro. Yeah, no doubt. No doubt, Matt. Yo, I know what you meant. Caesar's Palace with the $5. Dana, was she really your friend? Hemp, great job ignoring her. 80% of black women are overweight. How is that not below average?
Shut your dumb ass up. Next comment.
What? Mike Brown with the $2. Do y'all think y'all were like eights? Just curious.
Does Mike Brown think he's an eight? Just curious.
Mike would say he's average.
So he need not make those types of remarks.
He's just asking a question. Because I think we had this scale before. Because who's an eight? Rihanna?
I think we talked about that. Yeah. So no. Yeah,
who did you say was a 10? I forget.
Kelly Rowland.
You said Kelly Rowland was a 10. Rihanna was an 8.
Beyonce a 9. Like just to scale, make it easy to scale.
Okay. And then we're somewhere between 3 and 5. Man, fuck y'all. I'm a 7 at least.
Whatever, 5.5 because I'm a 7.
No, but you know what make it when you make it real by like putting people that everybody can kind of agree, you know, for the most part.
I mean,
like,
yeah, if I was a millionaire and had a makeup artist and a trainer and a chef, I would be cuter too.
Hey, if your aunt had a dick, she'd be your uncle.
Well.
And you might be coming that one day.
Because I don't know what to tell you. Shout out to Caesar's Palace with a $2 super chat. Moving on. 19.91 million baby mama. No. Black men. What is that?
Oh, there's there's 40. There's how many black people in it? How many black people in the United States? 40? 42 million? Is that it?
Yeah.
So yeah, I think it's only like you guys are like 21 million or 22 million, and we're like 19.9 or something.
Okay.
But there are 700,000 of us in prison.
And slice that into half for homosexuals as well, for gay men.
Half of the black men are gay? Come on, Ratchet. Come on, man. No. My bad. Yeah. 40. Yeah. 40. I said 14. I flipped the numbers in my head. My bad. Yeah. So, damn. Y'all crazy, man. Like, subscribe, tell a friend, tell a friend. Hit that like button right now if you can. That helps the channel. And we out.